Hello, students. We are going to talk about programming, mainly using variables and conditional statements and what's called logic. So we'll learn a little bit about that today. You have already completed the accelerometer, which was the rolling the die tutorial, and the rock, paper, and scissors tutorial in the micro bit site. And also have watched the codable video about variables. So let's talk a little bit more about variables. So computers are stupid. Computers don't know what to do unless you tell them exactly step by step what to do. That's why programming is so difficult. So to set up a variable, programs are filled with variables. For example, if I ask you in a program to give me your name, to type in your name, that is, the program is setting up a variable. So maybe X equals your name. It's just basically a little container. It's a little holder. It's a little spot in its memory that it can contain this information. So you have to define that spot for the computer first. Next, let's go on to what is logic. So logic is basically just some reasons or rules or a process to validate something. So when you validate something, you determine whether it is true or false. Is it real or fake, right? So think of Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes uses logic. That is his skill. To think about how something happened or what he can know from what he sees. So for example, if you know that A equals B and you know that B equals C, then what can you say A equals? So you can deduce, you can use logic to say that A equals C in this statement here. That is using your mind to figure out what A equals. So you have to use precise logical statements, and those statements are called conditional statements, all right? This is why it's under the logic area in your microbit programming interface there. So basically, conditional means depending on. So for example, I might say, depending on whether something is true or false. So for example, if I'm at school, I might get a drink at the drinking fountain. If I'm at home, I might get a drink out of the refrigerator. So depending on where I'm at determines where I get a drink, if you understand that. And so on a computer, you have to use a certain type of sentence, a certain type of language to tell a computer what is going on. And that language is if, then, else. So for example, if this is true, then this happens. If it's not true, then this happens. So for example, if I'm at home, then I get a drink out of the refrigerator. If I'm not at home, I get a drink out of the drinking fountain. That is a conditional statement. And it looks like this. So you start up here at the very top and you have a question. Basically, A is a question. Is this true or false? And that's what you ask the computer to determine. Basically, it compares, you could compare two different numbers, you could compare two different words, etc. If the computer determines that it's true, then it follows the path to the left. And it does B, whatever that might be. Else, If it's false, it goes and does the right-hand path to C. Okay? So that is, it sounds kind of complicated, but it's not very complicated actually. All right? So using this information, using what you've learned so far, I want you to do a challenge. And that is, pick one of these things. Or if you finish one, you can pick another one. All right? So you have the choice of making a truth or dare picker. You know that little game where you guys truth or dare? You can program your microbit to tell you whether it's truth or dare. You could make a Hogwarts sorting hat. It sorts you into one of the four houses at Hogwarts. The magic ball game where you shake the little, the eight ball, magic eight ball. You shake the little eight ball and it tells you no way. You ask it a question, right? And it tells you no way, probably, unlikely, or definitely. Make a compass out of the microbit. You can create a countdown timer from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, in seconds. You could do a higher or lower game where the microbit picks a number and you have to guess and determine what number it picked. Or you can make up your own challenge. If you have something that you want to investigate or learn, you can do that. To gain the 50 points for this assignment, all you're going to do is show me your program and show me how it works, and I will mark you off on my sheet and you will get 50 points. All right, good luck, guys.